as Sebastian Aho moves back into the middle with Seth Jarvis and Teuvo Teravainen up front. And here we go. Aho will get to the puck. Scoot out to the wing. There's 12:45 left here in the first period. Another chance, a low drive, and Anderson takes care of the Cartier drive. And if Justin Williams says that, I have to agree with him. So,
very true. I remember more on this in a minute.
There's an opportunity now for Bjorkstrand trying to shimmy, shake, and score. A little shoulder shake. He backed off Burns and goes upper 90. And Seattle grabs the lead 1-0.
And when you're in any process of changing, now Seattle was changing and they did so cleanly. Just have to make sure to get that puck deep at the offensive blue line. And I mean, just a super move. I mean, it's stopping and starting. The game is about stopping and starting. The way that Bjorkstrand stopped, gained separation, and the interior.
Jarvis will drop this one back for Aho. He'll spin, settle, trying to get a shot with Lemieux, but he got his pocket picked by Bjorkstrand, and he'll pull up. Now he'll settle one, and he'll come in. Shore goes through the five hole and scores. Devin Shore, set up by Bjorkstrand. Five hole through Anderson, and it's a 2-0 Kraken lead.
And made a play. And this thereafter leads to him flying the zone, knocking a puck out of midair, and settling it on his tape. He had just started his shift on time, then flies the zone. Puck was on edge and still is able to open up Anderson.
He'll be chopped down by Belmar. Kotkaniemi keeps it in again. Bunning. Fling that around Schultz, and DeCord will play it. And now Carolina comes up with a steal. Kotkaniemi, side of the net. Around for Bunning. For Natchez. They score! Oh, that line did the hard work. And Carolina on the board. It's 2-1. Marty Natchez with a loose change.
Clutch late third periods in overtimes last year. Dumoulin blew a tire. DeCord was indecisive. Indirected it to him. Dumoulin went heels to the ice. That allowed you to use the back of the net. And eventually, Natchez gets on the attacking side of the puck. Bunting finds it. And with fight, he gives Carolina life. And Carolina gets a late period goal, not giving up one like they have recently.
It wasn't exactly Apollo Creed teaching Rocky how to get back after it against Clever Lang. But it's those team-building moments. And somebody who knows how to throw hands, and Brendan Lemieux and Jack Drury seeking that advice that happened yesterday at practice.
But if you can get to that home plate first, especially with the way DeCord seeing the puck, you're going to have success.
I love how that graphic illustrates where it's coming from. And Larson into the Kane zone, drop for Everly. Everly tried to get it back, but Brady Shea with a stellar defensive play. Now Shea, he's got his motor going. Shea to the backhand across. Natchez drops it back. They score! Yes, Barry!
Shea desperately makes the play, kicks it, Dorothy Wizard of Oz style, from his left skate up to his tape. Eventually you have numbers. Heck of a pass, and Nate just makes an even better pass to Kotkaniemi on his offside. And in one motion, Kotkaniemi flings it on edge, almost harpoons it into the back of the net.
Seattle with the first two of this one, Carolina with the last two. Now Everly, with time winding down, just throws one towards Anderson's net. That misses everything, and we've got bonus hockey coming up. So there are the two defensemen. Stahl with Slavin and Burns, and Stahl wins it, and he will head directly to the bench. Burns off the boards for Slavin, getting the stick into McCann. 30 seconds left here in overtime. McCann gets through. Anderson makes the save. And then Burns clears it out to Aho.
He had the old reach around front, he did. He wasn't sure if he had it.
Well, he grabbed it, and now Natchez with it. Natchez sends it across. D'Angelo holding back across. Natchez, White scores! He does it again!
Transition the puck. D'Angelo had his best game of the season.